start, please.
Okay, everyone. Welcome to our social economic talk show today. And my name is Yu, and I'm your host. Today, our show has invited two experts. First, Ms. Mai Wen. She is a sociologist. And first, and the second, Mr. Wei. He is an economist. The topic of our talk show today is materialism and consumerism. Have a seat, please. Because our topic is kind of very theoretical, so I spend some first time to explain the two terms. First, materialism. We all know that is a major branch of philosophy, and it is a form of philosophical nomism. That means the materialist just believe in one thing, is the matter, and matter is the fundamental substance in the nature, and all the other things in the world, even our mind and conscious, is the matter's byproduct or epiphenomena. And throughout history until now, there are three main kinds of materialism. First, naive materialism. Naive materialism identifies the world with false specific elements, which is earth, water, air, and fire. And with these four elements and all the other things, it was created. And second, metaphysical materialism. This kind of materialism examines parts of the world in isolated environment, and the opposite with this kind of materialism is dialectical materialism. This kind of materialism examines parts of the world in relation to each other and in a dynamic environment. And you know how lay the foundation for this materialism is Karl Marx and Lenin developed. And let's move on to the second term, consumerism. And there are a lot of definitions of consumerism, but it all of them falls into two categories: positive consumerism and negative consumerism definition. First, positive consumerism, it is the study or practice of matching consumer with the trustworthy information. And or simply, positive consumerism just a consumer protection policy. And people who are anti-consumerism and who support simple living, and consumerism just an economic materialism, or consumerism is just excessive consumerism, meaning the customer buy a lot, use a lot, and waste a lot. So, the first, we discuss about the effect, because we all know that we can understand materialism, what it is, and now we just focus on the term of consumerism. First, let's welcome Mr. Wei. As an economist, it is an economist term, right?
Yes, it is.
So could you explain more about the term, and can you tell me how it affects our economy?
So firstly, the consumerism has a positive effect on the economy. Firstly, consumerism can respond to the higher demand of consumer and by creating the mass product. So when developed, it strongly depends on the development of industry. So from that point, the industry will develop, and it will open more work opportunity, attract the human resources to operate the line production. will lead the consumer to the higher demand, and they will need more service to make their life become more comfortable, and they also require a better quality variety of product. For example, when we talk about the suffering, we can think about two famous brands, it's Coca-Cola and Pepsi. And also in the company, they also have the variety of product. Coca-Cola, they have the Destiny, Pepsi, they have the Formula. And when many companies, they manufacture the same product, there will be a competition among these companies. And so the competition, the company will have the policy advertisement, and also they need a promotion to attract the consumer. So all the competition will bring the consumer the benefit. All the benefit will lead to the higher, the better living of the people.
So I kind of doubt it, because as you were saying, consumerism just bring a lot of benefit and doesn't help many bad side. Actually, not really, because when people have a better living, so they desire a luxury living. And when the demand of people is still spiraling, you understand the spiraling, the demand will become bigger, bigger, and bigger. So it will turn to the negative side. So let I ask Ms. Mai, as a sociologist, and can you give all of us some opinion about it?
Okay, thank you for your very interesting question. To answer this question, many scientific studies have shown that consumerism come up with many social problems, ranging from environmental degradation, moral degradation, higher debt, and health problems. In terms of environmental degradation, higher demand of products put too much pressure, excessive pressure on the natural resources like fossil fuel, water, and raw material. The manufacturer and production is need to explore the natural resources to produce a huge quantity of product and product. At the same time, they emit too much weight into the environment, and the consumer at the consuming state, when people purchase and give product, they throw too much plastic back. Auto or containers, that's really harm to our environment because it needs thousands to million years for degradation. And at the final step of the consumer process, when people use product, rather than reuse or recycle it, they tend to throw it away, and it makes our society become a throw away society. About moral degradation, people now they become too materialistic. But I mean, they are oriented to money too much, and they just want more and more, and never fair, so they become greedy, selfish. It's also lead to have many serious health disorder, like disorder both physically and mentally. Depression, isolation, and we are under the throwaway society, the consumer society, in under stress, too much pressure, and anxiety. Okay, in terms of higher debt, can you explain us more about it?
Because the people that they don't have, they have the financial limitation. First, they desire to buy in the luxury goods, so they will take the short-term loan. And such a the short, the payday loan to buy the luxury item. And that way, go bankrupt, they will commit the crime, and they commit suicide.
say through our presentation, and we want to emphasize on one thing. Consumerism is not good nor bad. Whether our society is good or not depends mainly on our way of living. And our message is to live environmentally friendly and we go green. And our message is buy less,
hold less,
live more.
Thank you.